In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this calendar heat map with just one line of Python code. Calendar heat maps are super useful for visualizing trends over time, like for example sales data to spot seasonal patterns. So without further ado, let us dive in. Let's say you want to visualize your sales data. Here I've got a spreadsheet with two columns, the date and the sales amount for each day. This dataset covers the entire year of 2024. And in the same folder as my spreadsheet, I also have a Jupyter notebook. By the way, you can also find the download links to both of the files in the description box below. Now, to create the calendar heatmap, we will be using a Python package called plotly-calplot. And you can install it with pip. For this demo, I'll also be using pandas, which you can also install via pip. And once that is done, I will start by importing pandas SPD, and I'll also import calplot from plotly-calplot. Next, I'll read in the sales data using pandas and display the first three rows of the dataset. And with that in place, we can now create the calendar heatmap. To do that, all you need is a calplot object. Just pass in your dataset as a pandas data frame and set the x and y axis to match your column names. And that's already it. When you run the cell, you will get an interactive heatmap. In this example, you can also notice a few patterns. It looks like we generally have higher sales on weekends, and you will also see that the sales are higher in July and especially during the holiday season in December. Now, let me also show you some customization options. First, you can enable a dark theme. To do this, just set the dark theme argument to true. And by default, there's also a small gap between the squares in the heatmap. If you would like, you can also adjust this gap. For example, you could set the gap to 5 or remove it completely by setting it to 0. By the way, if you don't specify the gap, the default value is 1. Alright, when I execute the code, you will see the two examples. One will have a larger gap between the squares, and the other one will have no gaps at all. Okay, next up, let's talk about colors. You can customize the colors by specifying a color scale. Calplot is actually built on top of Plotly, and Plotly actually offers many built-in color scales, and you can find their names in the Plotly documentation. Here, on this page, you can use the drop-down menu to check out the different color scales. And I will also make sure to include the link to this page in the description box below. So for my example, I will use blues. But you're actually not limited to the built-in color scales. If you want, you can also define your own color scales, just like I have done here, and then use them in the color scale argument. So when I execute this cell, you will see the two plots with the different colors. Lastly, you can also display the year as a title on your heat map and also customize the line width and color. Alright, and that's about it. That's how easy it is to create a calendar heat map from your data. Now, as a final step, you also might want to export your chart. And you can do that by exporting the figure object as an HTML file. When I run this code, a new HTML file will appear in my directory. This file now contains a fully interactive chart. And as I mentioned earlier, I will also upload this Jupyter notebook to GitHub, so you can test it out yourself. And on that note, I also recommend checking out the official documentation, which you can also find on GitHub. And you guessed it already, I will also leave the link to the repo in the description box below. Alright, so I hope you found this short video helpful. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.